You see him. He only has a two-weapon loadout with the three utility. This is something I talk about a lot. Ever since the removal of the pump, we've vaulted it. And I mean, it's definitely shaped, changed and shaken up the meta, rather.
Ooh. So clean by Taquito. No, but he did what he wanted, which was to get this building. Oh, gets a clean headshot onto his opponent, but he's got another one breaking in. There's so many players in this area. Native going down to that drum gun. Hate to see it with a loadout like his. He had that rift. He had a ton of shields that they're able to go. They don't need to go directly up, but they're still moving 14 more seconds until the storm closes, and they'll need to make another push. He's got this really neat little opening that we talked about earlier where they edit the floor to create a window. It's very safe unless you catch a player that's looking up at you with a heavy sniper, but doesn't seem to be the case this time. Getting a lot of eliminations, already sitting on 4 eliminations, lots of players left in the lobby, plenty of opportunities. See Taquito taking a lot of damage. Yeah, not a great position to be in. You saw how scantily he was building and blanketing on the high ground. He does have, does have that redeploy, so he's not so worried, but he needs to get some build resources as well for him. But he needs to make a decision here. He's gonna
take himself.
Oh, is that a double elim? No, let's get the elimination. Needs to pick up these resources, gets 20 builds total, goes for that ultimate high ground. Vix is there.
Vix, unfortunately, lands on the player to get the edit, the crack back down to 18 shields, 68 total HP. Goes down again, Kitty. What is Vix doing? It doesn't matter. The RPG comes out with 23. Baldi, Sama. Oh, my God.
Taste of his own medicine. Zill taking him out with that explosive. Now sitting on 4 eliminations. Still has 7 RPGs. Choosing to actually enter the storm to be safe. Looking for any build he can get. Finds Hachi hiding underneath that flat. Does get the elimination. Taquito still in the high ground, but still is tearing him apart. Taquito's lost all his shield to win. Doesn't have any builds, but so far all of his decision making has led him to a great position. And taking more shots cancels that campfire. Shots coming down from Taquito, and it's just a simple cleanup by Zill. Absolutely outstanding job not having any resources and pulling that off, but that is the power of the RPG. We just saw
the loadouts, you know, it's fine. It's fine. It's okay. Now, don't forget, guys, if you're just seeing it on the right side of your screen, the current NA East spots up for grabs are 6.
Nice shots coming out with this assault rifle. He doesn't need the Tommy gun. He doesn't need the meta. He's got his green assault rifle taking great shots, pulling out that gray napkin, getting some clean shots in now. Does enough damage for him to be able to convert an elimination onto Kiwi. Takes a couple shots, but...
Dubs here, we saw him dominating not that long ago. Here's to see those standings later on. A great pickup.
With the drum gun there by Dubs, picking up 2 eliminations now. He's going to get all these resources now as well. Actually, to look up above and take shots on him. So he's got a clear transition into the new zone. And this has been the difference between these placement points here when you have those rifts in these final moments.
That's right. Currently, as it stands, Macwood sitting on the highest ground.
Finds an
Elim there over on Volt, and now he's going to start a waterfall down. There is someone below him, and he does have the 2 shadow bombs as well.
Getting really clean shots onto his opponent, isn't able to convert to an elimination, but right away pushing up, catching this guy off guard. He Macwood just getting an elimination right away into another fight. Doesn't look like he was ready for it. The situation with this player here close and chooses to take the ultimate low ground. Sometimes this has a huge advantage for players. Doesn't have very many builds, so I'm assuming that is why that was his decision. And in a bit of a sandwich situation between Thome, ends up taking him out. He gets 4th place, 3 players remaining. Thome on the bottom, Dyslexic in the middle, and Tinny Jelly on that high ground in a heal-off situation here. So he needs to find an opportunity to use his RPG, and that might just be the perfect moment. He in the lock, taking out Dyslexic for that victory rail.
So not perplexed, he's going to probably do this. He's probably going to wait. He's going to hope that players... Okay, so he's already watching. He's on the other side of the storm here. He's just watching as these players with their back to the storm wall.
He gets that last shot, steals that elimination. Has he learned the perfect tracking of those shadow bombs already? That was absolutely mental. That player disappeared and he still got that elimination using that drum gun.
Oh, that was Zate. So I was literally, that's why I gasped earlier. I was going to say, we tuned in with Ghost Saf. They are duo, and because it's solos, obviously everyone's trying to compete, so you're going to be facing off against your potential duo partner. Yeah. painful as well. He's in the one by one, one over, and look at the ammo count right now, Kitty. Not looking great, but this could be huge. There's this player getting out of the open. What do you mean? He just double tapped these players and another one.
He didn't pick up any of the ammo though. See, he has no ammo in his assault rifle. He only has one clip in his drum gun right now. He is gonna have to do the best he can. He already expended through all of his resources. He just walked over four eliminated players, didn't pick up any of their loot. Now we're spectating Blue T, who just took him out. He is there with Vice though. Perplexy holding that low, able to find some time now to take his mini shields in. Goosh, you gotta be prepared for the rebuttal if you're gonna be breaking down that wall. Just absolutely destroys him. Janet gets taken down by Blue T, but the other two have been rifted. Two more builds before he's gonna have to drop down with Blue T in a 1v1 situation. It appears that it was a building situation. Now it's a 1v1. Vice and Perplexy. Perplexy has no more build. Vice could keep blanketing as long as he wants to drop build.
That was
an interesting
the sickest thing. Again, I am on my feet walking around.
On his roaming opponents, isn't able to pick up any eliminations, but getting some tanks. Now he's just got to wait for these south players. You see, he's on the mini-map, he's angled south. All these players need to rotate towards him. Picking up an elimination now. They're going up and over this hill here. Ryan Skodnik takes him out with that drum gun and continues to make the push. He needs to be breaking through all of his opponents' builds here.
Because especially when you're running through builds and someone's left a metal wall behind that you have to break through to get to safety, it's tough. This is a wood wall, thankfully. Wood ramp here on the left, thankfully. If that was metal, he would already be gone. He needs to find something.
He does.
No way. The chip damage and the storm.
Wow.
We have already been eliminated.
Eliminations already. All these players going into these late games with these early eliminations that are really, really paying off for them.
I like that he chose there. So he drops down on two players that are build battling, and he's like, I'm just going to back up and just 90 my way up. And look at this. He's already found an elim, reloads the rocket. This is huge. So Dubs is one playing for late game, just trying to make sure he can hit at least top 25. And then he's going to go on the offensive. He tries to trade out with someone, 30 down to 35. He's in the critical. He needs to find this shot. Down to 50. Oh, my. He picks it up. 45, 35, 25. Okay, my heart's racing right now. What he's hoping to do is pick up a player along the way to get more rockets. And unfortunately, okay, so that player decides to send rockets to the tart below, and he picks up Laner. They're on the descent phase. Dubs, you are absolutely destroying this lobby. Look at the players down below.
Oh, it's impressive. When you can be that consistent, this is week three. We still have 2 weeks left. It's anybody's game, Bala.
It's anybody's game, and you can actually see he's holding the turbo building feature right now. On all the walls, finally, Excels goes right behind him. He wasn't making noise in that all the time. He was spinning around, making sure that if a wall was going to get heavy sniped or something like that, he would have the time to quickly replace it, and then Excels getting into his box.
But is going to try to preemptively cross the lava, gets a massive headshot, on slide, takes him out completely. You lava to see it. Rogue Shark here now sitting with two eliminations, 54 points. But look at this zone, Bala. This is a very precarious situation for him. He does have the shadow bombs, using them to rotate, but players are building him out. He is going to have to make some quick edits. Get Thwifle. Thwifle gets completely annihilated by Shark. Shark, you are on a tear right now.
Yes.
Another headshot onto Wanro. Oh my goodness, Bala. He can't be stopped right now.
That was ridiculous. I was going to talk about how the shadow bombs sometimes can be a little uncomfortable because you could get trapped in somebody's box and you can't do anything about it. He did end up coming out of the shadow bomb, make his own box, and Thwifle ended up falling into that. And then another player too, Shark, using that combat shotgun as well. An advantage being the fast fire rate, the quick reload time, the large clip. Kind of put yourself in a little bit of a pinch right now, and that might be the end. No, he takes out Tuxi, so now 1v1, Rogue Shark. What a play with that combat shotgun takes him out. He still has that drum gun too, and an RPG to knock out Popfast if he wants to. Popfast making sure he gets through that tree, jumping up to make sure no storm ticks are going to get taken, but he is going to take some. Fortunately, not able to hit those combo reticles, so breaking the tree faster. Now the campfire is coming in, making sure that he heals up. Here's the RPG, knocks him directly into his box. It's going to be a full-out brawl.
Wow.
And Rogue Shark is going to come out on top. Again, the close range engagements, he did it time and time again. We saw him take out Thwifle in the box.
In this lobby, and now no placement points, you're only taking your elimination points home with you.
Klaus really interested in this neighbor. Oh, that was a great play onto Linane too.
No, my fellow Canadian. And then I'm so.
See what he can do here in the World Cup Online Opens. Trying to qualify for New York.
Hernando does fall. We're looking back at Langeac here. I mean, health-wise, not doing too great. Build-wise, not doing too great either. But anything can change in a split second. It takes one elimination on one person. Is he going to nail this one? He does. He gets St. Jesus. And then I thought he was going to take out Yuzin as well. But he wasn't able to clutch that elimination. We see Hornet. Zayd, I'm so sorry, man. But Pistola taking some shots here. Ends up connecting on Derpy Troller. These names today.
Yeah, I love them. They're funny. They're hilarious.
They're amazing.
I've seen Derpy Troller multiple times before too. What a shot there. Gandhi goes down. Unfortunately for him, dab, dab, dab. Nope, not in this lobby. Pistola trying to break his way through the metal. I think that was the wrong choice. Yeah. He now needs to use the AR. He's going to get held up, I believe. Yes, the other wall comes in and that's it, I think, for you. Oh, why are you doing it? The siphon is about to come in if he gets this. Yes, Ivan Lag goes down. So Pistola, you barely just live. He's got 60 HP right now in a dream. What can you do? The tactical 26. Shotgun as well. No materials. Class finally takes him out. And one more player to find. Class onto Hornet.
Wow. Unbelievable ending there.
Everybody doing their best George of the Jungle impression right now. Macwin up in the tree. And it's funny because you don't want to be up there because you can't build, you can't defend yourself. So that's what happened. Macwin picking up those two eliminations.
I just realized his name is Mac Wood.
Oh my goodness.
Quickly, things can change. We are at zone 7 right now, 18 seconds before the circle completely closes. Keanu the streamer taking out Hydev, and Macwood on high ground, just raining down shots. He's at 5 eliminations now, Bala.
5 eliminations, and I love this use of the redeploy, these short jumps. Where he was when we first hopped in with him, about 120, now he's at 5. And because of this glider redeploy usage, and the solid peak box usage, he's actually just using a lot of people's old builds, it's not even his. No, he's finding a lot of eliminations for it.
He's gonna have to be careful here though. He doesn't have a lot left. He doesn't have any builds. And there it is, you know. 5 players left though, so we are in our last threshold before the final placement, which would be a victory royale.
It's gonna have a free rotation. All these players down below are gonna struggle. You can see Tezzy, he sees you. Tezzy, he jumped over him at the last second. That was critical. But unfortunately, now he has to make the hard trek up. I don't know if he has any more shadow bombs. Do you have any more shadow bombs? Because it's gonna be very important for you to get up this. No,
no more
we can see in his inventory. Kriz, all you have to do is wait. Yes,
he
here
knows
goes.
It.
It's starting to go off the side. He's gonna start trying to 90
Kriz
up.
Knows.
No, can you do it? Kriz starting to make his date. Terrible as well as he's stuck down below and the drum gun is going to come in. Kriz, a good play there to position himself properly, and that's how you get the victory royale. But nice attempt there from Tezzy.
Snood versus Zayd. We love to see it. Snood taking some shots here with the compact SMG, trying to break those metal walls onto the player just below him here. He is going to have to watch that peek, opening up a door as opposed to just a window so that he can easily run out and finish the player. He does have him on white damage, and there it is. Snood secures his 3rd elimination of the day on Homie Law.
In competitive Fortnite NA East.
Down to 20 players now, so first threshold for Linane has been reached. Dictating, taking shots on Asgarito, does end up taking him out, takes one tick of zone damage. That takes him at 51 health right now. He is going to have to play this very carefully, try to make a third party, is opting to go for the early rotation so that he can stay in a box, use edits, and hopefully get an elimination here.
Yes.
Does he get it? He does. Excellent, excellent play by Dictating there.
Perfect there, and he's going to continue the fire onto Dolbs, and I believe that Snood there. And one thing I wanted to point out was how he used that glider redeploy. Again, I talked about the short jumps as he continues to get the stairs! Is the trap gonna finish it? No, he does go down to Fireko, unfortunately there for Dictating. That's the end of his run. And Fireko at 52 points right now. Remember, the top 6 in the qualifying.
Snood just got taken out.
Snood gets taken out as well, so unfortunately that might be the end of his run for New York. Again, just falling short. Snood was so close. In week number 3, it's all coming down. Everybody is firing on each other. There's 3 shadow bombs right now. Mega just took out 1 in the elimination feed as well. Colorful now, 4 eliminations, 61 points. Who's going to come out on top right now? Pistola taking a bit of high ground. Where is this going? Zayd just staying. He's not really committing to anything because he knows the situation. He knows all the players in here. He knows the leaderboard standings as well. Last time he checked, Vice gonna take out Colorful. So he's putting himself back in the running as well. Who's getting the ticket in this game? Who is gonna be the one coming to New York? Pookie, it's coming down to a top four now.
Top four, and Vice sitting on ultimate low ground with that RPG poised and ready. Is Zate gonna take out Hornet? He is now raining shots down. Zate falls down. Vice takes him out with the RPG. Is Zate going to start shooting? He is, but Vice, does he take high ground?
Yes, Zate with the victory royale. 68 points to win. That Elim.
Breaking it down in there. So. You see, first of all, we got Dubs and Clicks. Dubs, because he took home that $5,000 as well, is in that perma highlight. But both of these players had previously qualified, so six spots go through. Ready? Here's the breakdown. Zate got it. Very last match with that victory royale going through. Colorful also got it, pushing through with his elims and that top five finish. Mega was in that match and pushed up as well during that one. Unfortunately, Snood being taken out was in a tiebreaker with Class for that final spot.
Not like
63
this.
Points. So let's go in and we'll take a look at Class's match history so we can kind of break down what ended up going on there. And the difference, that first tiebreaker, the first one is points. If you're tied there, it goes to Victory Royale's Class taking home. A number of them there got 1, 2, 3 up on the board with those first places. So Snood, unfortunately, not being able to pick one up, and Class going through with a dominant